for one fall. This is an international dream match. First, at 205 pounds, from the beautiful city of churches, Adelaide, South Australia, he's a two-time NWA Australian National Champion, a former EPW Tag Team Champion, a former EPW Champion, the World Beater, Damian Slater! Now, introducing his opponent, at 167 pounds, from Los Angeles, California, he is a former TNA X Division Champion, a former WWE Cruiserweight Champion, and the winner of the inaugural WWE Cruiserweight Classic, Cruiser Great, he is Phil and Flash, T.J. Perkins!
This is the match that everyone has been talking about, the international dream matchup between Damian Slater and the man that has come from the other side of the world, none other than T.J. Perkins.
This is going to be epic. That's not overselling it. These two men, two of the greatest technical wrestlers in the entire world. Didn't say Perth, didn't say Australia, the entire world. And they're about to get it on right now in an EPW ring.
Very excited for this one, as is the entire audience who's crammed in here to the Gate One Theatre. This story takes us all the way back to 2007. A young 19-year-old Damian Slater, he first travelled to the United States and mixed it up with T.J. Perkins. These guys first met each other. These guys know each other well, have kept in touch ever since. He made multiple trips to the United States. These guys have gotten to know each other, trained together for so long. Never had a match against each other before.
And it's an absolute treat that we're seeing it now as they exchange holds in the middle of the ring, trying to get that early advantage.
Of course, Damian Slater and T.J. Perkins here in Australia. They tag team together on a tour that took place of all places, the Big Day Out, the music festival, part of Lucha Vaboom. But of course, since then, these men both got to hang out again during the WWE Cruiserweight Classic in 2016. Of course, Damian Slater, he went out in the first round up against Tajiri, where it was that man, T.J. Perkins, who won the entire damn thing, becoming the WWE Cruiserweight Champion, as well as winning the Cruiserweight Classic.
You have to wonder what would have happened if these two crossed paths in that tournament there. As you said, they know each other very well. Slater was one step ahead of him there, making sure he missed that dropkick. So we're just lucky to be able to see this. And we finally answer that question of what if.
What if indeed. Of course, both men now locking up. T.J. Perkins with the side headlock. Of course, Damian Slater, he's done a lot of things on the global stage as well as here in Australia. But he needs this win over T.J. Perkins to solidify his status as the world beater. Of course, T.J. Perkins, he's wrestled with New Japan Pro Wrestling, PWG, Ring of Honor, Impact Wrestling, where he was an X Division champion. Of course, WWE, where he won the Cruiserweight Classic and the Cruiserweight Championship. And just last week, he took part of the Super J Cup. T.J. Perkins, of course, being in WWE, he also walked away from it. Damian Slater just can't believe that T.J. Perkins has done everything Slater had dreamed of and more, and then walked away from it.
Well, at the moment, Slater will be thinking about the torque of the knees against his spine there. Oh, wait a minute. He did think ahead there, managed to get out of it, and takes a breather on the outside. It's a sliding doors moment, really, between these two. At that Cruiserweight Classic, Slater thought the world was his oyster. He calls himself the world beater because he has proved himself. But then after the tournament was done, he didn't hear back. Whereas TJ just kept on going from strength to strength. He's featured heavily on all the programming as the beacon of the Cruiserweight division.
And with good reason, this is one of the world's best that you could ever hope to see. That's right now, whoa! Beautiful head scissor takedown.
Slater thought he had got out there, but TJ had other plans.
Oh, we've seen this before from Slater.
So it's TJ. He knew what was coming. Went back into a pinning predicament in his own.
Goes for an arm drag. Perkins now.
With the bridge back into the backslide of sorts.
This is beautiful. This is amazing. This is what it's all about. And it's happening all inside an Explosive Pro Wrestling ring. As I mentioned, these two guys are good friends. This is not some personal blood feud. Oh, just as I said that.
But that's not a personal blood feud. That is Damian Slater with a point to prove. Sometimes when you've got a mate who has perceived to be better than you and has had the better career than you, you've got a chip on your shoulder. So they might be mates, but Damian Slater's not here to make friends. He's here to prove a point and get that victory.
So true. And of course, in recent times, TJ Perkins Online has been doing the hashtag alternate ending tour. He has lots to prove and wants to show the world that this is the real TJ Perkins. So it's just as important for Perkins to get a win here over Damian Slater. The fact these guys know each other so well and have done for so long and seen each other.
Look at the strength of that bridge there. Sorry to interrupt, Olsen, but Damian Slater with the core strength to maneuver his way around and turn the tables on TJ.
No one could ever mistake the athleticism of both competitors in this one. Perkins now finding his way out of this one. He's got him up in. Whoa, how about that? Keeps hold of it too. Slater gets the shoulder up.
Those vice-like legs of TJP. As soon as you get your head caught in there, you know that no good is going to come for the next few seconds.
Perkins again.
Spins it around.
Got him locked in tight. Slater now, there you go.
And that's the thing with guys who've got this technical ability, the likes of TJP, the likes of Damian Slater, people see them do those head scissors and go, oh, they must be quick, or they must be quick. But they are, but they also have to have strength in those legs to be able to move the entire body of the other person down to the canvas.
They do it oh so well as, look out, here we go.
Slater looks bemused. What is TJP cooking up?
Gets out of that one with style. Look at Slater's face, says it all, he's got him up now. As he just wraps up Damian Slater.
Slater doesn't stick in there for long, using his neck strength there to get the move countered there. A little bit of a muffler stretch, but oh, wait a minute, TJP looking for the roll up.
These guys have got counters for anything either man can throw at each other. Just trying to outdo each other at every turn. Of course, in the intro video that we saw that you may have seen online prior to this matchup, Slater said he needs this more than anything.
TJP! Turnabout is fair play. Took the handshake away, gave him the dab action.
Slater not impressed now, there you go.
And this is the first time we've seen some real heavy strikes added to this match. There's been a lot of beautiful chain wrestling and grappling, and that little snub there has angered the world beater.
Slater, of course, very articulate with his strikes, as we've seen many times before here in EPW. Irish whip now. Perkins. Nice cover, but Slater gets his shoulders up.
Wait a minute, hooking both the legs and arms.
Look at that, what a variation of what would normally be a sharpshooter, but he's got the arms in on this one. How about that? Of course, keep in mind, TJ Perkins started wrestling training when he was 13 years old.
Bridging back.
Beautifully done there with the chin lock as well.
But the, not for us to criticise, but the mistake that TJP might have made there when he had that variation of sharpshooter on, he had the arms of Damian Slater pinned in, which, as you saw there, Damian Slater was able to crawl to the ring as soon as he went for that different manoeuvre. So maybe it may be an error in the game plan there, or maybe he's just setting it up for something else.
Slater hits the mat, but TJ Perkins. That could be a game changer in this matchup. The crowd is loving every single second of this action, as we are too. Slater looks like he's in a bad way now. Of course, referee Matthew Clark keeping an eye, making sure he can go on.
Your arm, your elbow's not meant to snap in that way. Could be a matter of moments. We're expecting this big escalation of a match, but I don't see how many people could actually go on. That sort of targeted attack on the elbow and the arm. Slater showing a lot of guts there to want to continue on and get the left shoulder up.
Perkins now firmly in control. Nice scoop slam there. What's he going to go for? Oh, beautifully done. Goes up and over, hooks the leg as well. Slater, he's hurting, but he's still kicking out. This means so much to him.
Well, that's a very good point you make there, Olsen. He's hurting and it means so much. We would have noticed, well, as he made his entrance there, he told the Untouchables family to go back to the back. So he's obviously, with that point to prove, wanting to do this by himself, which is very admirable.
This means far too much for him to get his fellow Untouchables members involved in this matchup. Perkins, oh, going straight back to work on that shoulder as well. Side Russian leg sweep. Slater has come out and said that he loves TJ Perkins, but he can't accept not being at the top where TJ stands right now. He says on his best day, he's as good as TJ Perkins has ever been, and he needs to show the world just that. But the odds are stacked firmly against him right now. Perkins is going to work on that arm and shoulder of the world beater Damian Slater now.
And that's the thing, it's all about showing the world that not only he can hang, but he is just as good, if not better, than TJ Perkins. Just because the career pathways went in different ways doesn't mean that Damian Slater is any less a wrestler. And again, it's going to be interesting to see this version of Damian Slater. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, just as we say that, using the referee to his advantage there, bringing in the neck breaker there, the 2-on-1 handicap.
Slater's offense is like lightning. We've seen it so many times before here in Explosive Pro Wrestling, but it never ceases to amaze and impress me. Right now, the snapmare takedown to TJ Perkins. He's got his foot on the face as well. Whoa! Just grinding the boot heel. And a drop kick to go with it. Slater may be hurt, but he sure as hell isn't ready to give up.
So they're seeing this friendly competition, and I use that term loosely. Escalate and escalate. You wouldn't have thought that you'd see a boot scrape at the beginning of the match, but now, as the stakes get higher and the match wears on, both men will get more desperate.
Oh, here we go, surfboard stretch. Slater.
Well, TJ grew up here. He's a Los Angeles native, so he's used to surfboards of a different nature.
Slater is wrenching back. Look at that! My goodness! Just wrenching back on Perkins.
Your body's not meant to wrench back that way, especially with Damian Slater holding you there. Maybe, see there, he shook out his elbow. So maybe the effects of that earlier onslaught on there is, caused him to break the hold when he would have wanted to hold that for a lot longer then.
One thing you can notice is that whilst this match started with very fast, quick pace, trading of holds, it is slowed down now. It's a lot more methodical. Both men are being smarter and not just instinct and reactive. Two count there.
That's what makes these two men two of the very best in the world. It's because they're adaptable, they can change their game plan. We've seen it before with Damian Slater here in EPW, that if one plan's not quite working or if he wants to accentuate the damage, he'll shift gears. So it'll be interesting to see, as this phase of the match continues, what will happen to the game plan of both men.
Slater now having some words to referee Matthew Clark. Of course, this hasn't been a massive year for Damian Slater. He's lost a few matchups. He, of course, got a win over Julian Boyd, but he had a shot at the EPW Championship.
That shot reverberated here in Gate 1 Theatre.
Of course, after losing that matchup for the EPW Championship against the Don Michael Morleone, Slater kind of seemed a little bit lost, unsure of what was next for him. And when this opportunity presented itself, you better believe he jumped at the chance. This is a match that has never taken place before. Either competitor has never had a chance to face each other. That's why it means so much to both competitors to get the win here tonight at EPW's Hell or High Water.
Slater taking his time to chastise the crowd.
Perkins with the foot up straight to the face of Slater. He's not done yet by a long shot. 2 feet that time. Slater ducks the clothesline, gets the feet up, giving TJ Perkins a taste of his own medicine right there in the mouth. Then again, you just don't know what's around the corner from either competitor. These guys are as quick and as sharp as can be. Case in point.
caught the leg. It was almost as if he was going for an enziguri, but shifted the position and threw Damian Slater over at the top there. That's what you're saying there, you don't know what's next. These two men, they can change what they're thinking in a moment. And how can you prepare for that as a competitor?
They're both very smart competitors, and they almost mirror each other in the way they like to conduct themselves with inside the squared circle. This makes this match even more of a treat to watch. So thank you for checking it out. Of course, follow EPW on all forms of social media. We're on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube as well, and you can see all other EPW shows at our Vimeo account. Slater now with a look of determination on his face. TJ Perkins still flat out on his back as now he sits up. Still fight left in both competitors. The conditioning of these men is well off the charts. It's going to take something big for this one to end.
It doesn't take a rocket surgeon. Just look at them. You see the shape. The both men are in. Straight across the jaw.
Slater reverses the Irish whip in. Perkins off the ropes. The forearm strike.
Nips up for good measure as well.
This guy's putting on a clinic here. Oh, he's going for the three amigos now. Maybe not.
That changed direction on you there.
You just don't know what's next.
That's the thing, you know, as soon as he rolls that leg over, we were thinking it, Slater was probably thinking it, but he changed it up. Here goes TJP. Oh, whoa. Springboard with the drive-by as well at the same time.
Top rope now. Nice crossbody, he's got the leg hooked as well, and Slater just gets the shoulder up in the nick of time.
2 3/4 there, it was a beautiful, beautiful crossbody there.
He's going,
wait a minute.
Got to go for that, the detonation kick. Won in many a matchup before.
Slater sensed that needed to desperately get out of that situation.
Like we've said, these guys know each other so well. Oh! Lance Slater down with that DDT. Is it going to be enough? Not this time. These guys, as I've said, I've spoken to them backstage, that they keep in touch regularly. It's not like this is some sort of deep-heated feud. It's just the spirit of competition within the sport of professional wrestling that is keeping these men kicking out each and every time, throwing every single thing they have at each other. It is all part of the beauty of pro wrestling. Such a treat to see here at EPW. He's got him up that fireman's carry. Could he be going for the detonation kick? Slater senses it coming, gets out of that one. Whoa!
Inverted atomic drop. Gets him keeled over. Oh, running knee straight to the side of the head.
On target to that temple. TJ Perkins gets the shoulder up. He's traveled a long way to be here on the other side of the planet.
That's the thing, he's traveling. He hasn't traveled here just to put on an exhibition. He hasn't traveled here just to put on a nice show. He's here to win the match. He wants to leave all the fans here in the Gate 1 Theatre here in EPW with a lasting impression that he was challenged man-to-man by Damian Slater, and he came away as the better.
That's right, he wants to beat the world beater.
Wait a minute, Slatality. DJ sends to coming.
He's got one arm. Two now. No, wait, Slater. Lights his way up. Oh, beautifully done by Slater. Leans back with the hooked leg.
Not quite enough. Our announcer, Jones Good, reached for the microphone. He thought that might have been it there. And I will say this, apart from a few fleeting moments, I am impressed with there's still that level of sportsmanship. It's still wanting to prove that they are better and they're not resorting to anything cheap. So, well, I say that and be thinking more of Damian Slater. Wait a minute, here goes a roll up. Two. Oh.
Slater was trying to cinch in an STF, but Perkins turned it into a roll up. These guys, they have counters for counters for counters. Oh! Slater just planted him, hooks the leg once again.
Thought maybe the extra impact coming off the second rope there with that DDT would be enough. The DDT, devastating maneuver in its own right, originated by Jake the Snake Roberts. That variation from the second rope just adds further brutality. But TJP, credit to him, fighting hard and not allowing that to be the end of the match.
He's kicked out, but he's not moving too well after that. Slater just picking him up off the canvas. we're going to see next. Slater. Perkins up on that top rope.
Strength to dead weight him up there. TJ doesn't look like he's with us here at the moment. A very precarious situation here, Olsen.
Slater taking a bit of time to talk to the audience. It's the focus on the task at hand, I reckon. Right now he's got him up.
If he
nails this, it is going to be all over. Make no mistake about it. Perkins now goes through.
Perkins was aware of that himself. Did not want to be up there. Straight hands there from Slater. Nothing pretty about that. Oh, here we go. TJP.
As quick as can be, straight out. Someone's going to go for a superplex, but Slater's putting the brakes on, locking his legs tight around those turnbuckles as neither man can get any leverage right here.
At this stage of the match, if they go over the top, it could be the end of the match. There's been a lot taken out of both men. Jostling for position. Who's going to prevail? Slater goes up. No, Slater gets back down.
There's a gasp wondering what's going to happen here. And oh, superplex!
And the rollover. Here we go. No, into the brainbuster.
Right in the middle of the ring.
Count him.
Oh. Referee Matthew Clark.
Oh!
Wow, what a shot to the head. Perkins, here we go. He's going to go for it.
Detonation kick.
Detonation kick! Right on the mark. Slater is done.
Count him out. One, two, there's
the
three.
Oh, he's got a foot on the rope! Slater gets his foot on the rope. Referee Matthew Clark, he's seen it. He's called it. TJ Perkins can't believe it.
Great officiating there. Ringbell Mel was begrudgingly getting the hammer ready, but no, Damian Slater, the wherewithal, to get that left foot onto the rope, breaks the count, and this match, thankfully for all of us here, continues.
As a chant of Let's Go Slater erupts in the building, they're not normally fans of Slater's work. I guess it's the hometown hero.
We both have terrible hearing. I wasn't sure I was hearing that correctly, but that is definitely Let's Go Slater. The crowd firmly behind the world beater. What is going on?
What's going on? It's an amazing matchup as both men trading shots now. Oh, hard forearm there by Slater. And again. Oh. Oh, Perkins!
The quickness of that kick!
Oh, super kick! Right on the jaw! Things not looking good now for TJP. Slater looks like he's firmly in the driver's seat, but he's got to do something. He's got to do something big to make it count.
Oh, wait a minute. What a counter! Is that the cross arm bar?
That's right. He's got him in a cross arm breaker. Slater. Got the STF locked in now, and it's right in the middle of the ring, right over that EPW logo. Great ring positioning there by the world beater.
EPW fans saying tap, 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 tap. Slater earning their respect. They're wanting TJP to pound the mat three times here, but he's reaching, he's clawing, he's centimeters away.
Slater drags him to the middle of the ring. Perkins is on. Wait!
Oh my God!
That's that cross arm breaker. He's put in a lot of work for the arm and the shoulder of Slater in this matchup already. Both men going for broke with their holds here in this part of the matchup. Slater knows he needs the win. He wants his win so
dragged
bad.
Dragged him back to the center of the ring. There's nowhere to go here for Damian Slater. Oh wait, upright.
Ooh. Perkins.
Gonna be going for that heel hook. We've seen TJ
win. He's got
win.
The heel. He's got the knee bar. He's locking it in. He won the Cruiserweight Classic with a similar maneuver there. Dragged him straight back to the middle. Perkins now. Perkins. He's come a long way here. He knows how much Slater wants his win, but he wants it just as much. Something's got to give. Where can Slater go?
He's got nowhere to go. Body go to the referee for dear life. Oh, no. Slater using the referee to break the hold.
It's not what we wanted to see, but oh, just the slight advantage that Slater needed. Super kick. Let's get him up.
Slater!
Fatality! He nails the Slater. One, two, and three. Slater has done it. Slater has gotten the win over TJ Perkins.
Unbelievable, Olsen. Unbelievable action and an unbelievable result.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner, the world beater, Damian Slater!
What a tremendous matchup by two of the world's best here at Explosive Pro Wrestling's Hell or High Water. TJ Perkins came a hell of a long way to be here. And I'd like to thank him for taking part in this event, putting on one hell of a matchup that none of us will soon forget.
One man who's definitely not going to forget this anytime soon is Damian Slater. Damian Slater winning the match, winning the adulation and respect. There may be question marks about using the referee to break that hold that he looked like he was done for, but take nothing away from the ring presence, the savvy, the ability. Damian Slater stands tall.